Modern warfare isn't that simple. A beginner with basic knowledge can easily tell LY-80 can shoot down Su-30MKI and Rafale by simply judging its maximum altitude ceiling. But here is where people is wrong. There is a thing called anti-radiation missile that hunts radars. IAF Su-30MKI comes with KAH-31P anti-radiation missile or ARM having 110 km range on KH-58 UARM with 250 km range. Both have terminal speed of more than Mach 3.6. It can destroy LY-80 long before Su-30MKI gets into LY-80's engagement range of 40 km. Such operations are called CDOR suppression of enemy air defense. LY-80 is powered by semi-active radar homing or SARH guidance. SARH-based SAM have both advantages and disadvantages. The guiding radar for SARH cannot be jammed since it's land-based and hence powerful enough to counter jamming. However, the advantage here is the disadvantage itself since SARH surface-to-air missile requires continuous guidance from the surface guiding radar which transmits waves, because SARH missiles doesn't have integrated radar seekers. The transmitted waves gets reflected and received by waves receiver in the missile. It means if the ground radar is switched off, the missile practically becomes an unguided rocket and can't home itself towards the target. This is where ARM comes in handy. The ARM has the upper hand here since LY-80 guiding radar can't switch off its radar or it will lose the already launched SAM. LY-80 can destroy low-speed ARM but again, KAH-31P and KH-58U have greater chance of destroying the radar even when the ground radar is switched off in case of ARM threat, mostly because of its sheer speed of Mach 3.6. Sorry to say this, but the remobilization time of LY-80 radars isn't enough to escape such ARM. By the time the radars detects the ARM, it would be too late to put back the hydraulic stabilizers of the radar truck and start the engine to remobilize. In case you are wondering if LY-80 can shoot down these Russian ARM, then you are wrong here. LY-80 can engage Mach 0.8 or subsonic cruise missiles at 50 meter altitude with minimum and maximum engagement range of 3.5 kilometers and 12 kilometers respectively and success rate of 60% only in case of subsonic cruise missiles. It means the probability of successfully engaging supersonic cruise missiles by LY-80 is near zero. The reaction time of this SAM is also high at 12 seconds. Which is not enough. While this Russian ARM have speed above Mach 3.6, LY-80 can only dream of shooting it down. And I don't need to tell about Rafale. It's a complete next level fighter, way more capable than Su-30MKI in seed operations. Conclusion. No, it can't destroy Su-30MKI and Rafale. One piece of advice for LY-80 operators is abandon their radar trucks and run away if they value their life, once they get to know an ARM is approaching towards them. Thank you everyone for watching this video.